Aleluya, Jesús. Aleluya. Esta noche quiero hablar por unos momentos.
And I want to entitle this call to be a light. Aleluya.
Llamar al tema a ser la luz.
You know the first time the Bible speaks about the light.
¿Sabes que la primera vez de la Biblia dice que el Señor hizo la luz?
When God spoke.
El Señor habló.
He said, "Let there be light."
Y dijo, "Sea la luz."
And there was light.
Y vino la luz.
From the very beginning.
Desde un principio.
He was talking about the light that would come into the world.
La luz que venía al mundo.
And to lighten it.
A alumbrar.
To bring light.
A traer luz.
Hallelujah. I want to go. I don't have it in my. I'll just read it here first. Hallelujah. It says in John chapter 1, verse 4. I'll just read these verses before I get to. Said in him was life, and the life was the light of men. Christ's life in you is what lights up your life. Yes. It says, as the light shineth in darkness. And darkness comprehends it not.
La luz brilló y las tinieblas no pudieron comprenderlo.
Hallelujah. And there was a man sent from God whose name was John.
Había un hombre llamado Juan.
And the same came for a witness to bear witness of the light.
Él vino para dar testimonio de la luz.
That all men through him might believe.
Para que todo aquel hombre crea.
He was not that light.
Él no era la luz.
But was sent to bear witness of that light.
Pero fue mandado para ser testigo de esa luz.
And that was the true light.
Y esta era la verdadera luz.
Which lighteth every man that cometh into the world.
La luz que alumbra todo el hombre del mundo.
And we know who that light is.
¿Tú sabes quién era esa luz?
It's our Lord Jesus Christ.
Es el Señor Jesucristo.
Who is the light of the world.
Quien es la luz del mundo.
And we are called but to bear witnesses.
Y esto ha venido para
dar testimonio
de esa luz que venía al mundo.
His whole intent in his first coming
was to
open our eyes to his salvation.
Para venir a la salvación.
That we also might become the light of the world.
Que nosotros también seamos la luz del mundo.
To reach those that are in darkness.
Para alcanzar a aquellos que están en tinieblas.
And only through the true light which is Christ.
Y por esta verdadera luz que es Cristo Jesús.
Can we reach the whole world.
Que podemos poder
I want to go now to the book of Exodus chapter 19.
Voy al libro de Éxodos, el capítulo 19.
Verse 1 through 10.
Versículo 1 a 10.
Because initially,
porque inicialmente,
the nation of Israel was called
la nación de Israel fue llamado
to be that light to the world
para ser esa luz del mundo,
and become a witness to all the nations.
Que fuera testigo de todos los,
but as you read through the word of the Lord, you begin to realize
pero cuando tú vienes a ver
they were not all, they were called to be a light,
que no todos fueron
but they were not the true light.
Pero no fue la verdadera
the true
luz.
Light is none other than
la verdadera
our Lord
luz
Jesus
había
Christ.
Más que el, Señor Jesucristo.
But they were called to be a light to the nations,
porque
to the Gentile
que fuera
nations.
Una luz para las naciones.
It says in the third month when the children of Israel were gone forth out of the land of Egypt, the same day came they into the wilderness of Sinai.
En el mes tercero de la salida de los hijos de Israel de la tierra de Egipto, en el mismo día llegaron al desierto de Sinaí.
And actually before they were given the Ten Commandments, they were called to be the light of the world and to be the priests of the Lord Jesus Christ. So the God has always wanted to bear witness of the light,
testimonio de esa luz,
but especially of the true light,
especialmente de la verdadera
which lights
luz,
up every man that comes into this world,
de la luz para que el Señor brillara a todos
which
los ojos,
is our Lord Jesus Christ.
¿Cuál es el Señor Jesucristo?
Hallelujah. And anytime you see light in the word,
todo el tiempo que
you know it's talking
luz,
about bringing forth the light into the lives of men or give them the understanding.
Para iluminar al hombre, dar entendimiento.
First that they need to be saved.
Porque necesitaban ser salvos.
I believe the first time the light comes to you
la primera vez que vino
is about
la luz
your salvation.
Y trajo tu salvación.
The second time, which I call
la
the reawakening,
es el verdadero despertamiento.
Is later in your life,
después en tu
when
vida,
the Lord comes to reawaken you to his divine purpose
y te despierta
in your,
para un
in your
propósito
life.
Divino en tu vida.
And one of these divine purposes, as you look
porque
through the Word,
divino propósito, dice
that
la
we
palabra,
become the light
para que veamos
to the
la
world.
Luz, la luz al mundo.
It's a commandment of the Lord
ese es un mandato del
that
Señor.
We become the light of the world.
Que venimos a ser la luz del mundo.
Now let's go to verse 2 of Exodus chapter 19.
Vamos al versículo 2 de Éxodos 19.
It says, and they were departed from Rephaim, and were come to the desert of Sinai, and had pitched in the wilderness, and there Israel camped before the mount.
Había salido de Refidim y llegaron al desierto de Sinaí y acamparon en el desierto. Y acampó allí Israel delante del monte.
Here in this call, when God calls Moses up to the mountain,
aquí llamó a Moisés,
he began to tell him, I want Israel to be the light.
Y dijo, yo
the light to all the other nations.
Luz del mundo y que dé luz a todas las naciones.
Let's go to verse 3.
Versículo 3.
And Moses went up unto God, and the Lord called unto him out of the mountain, saying, Thus shalt thou say to the house of Jacob, and tell the children of Israel.
Moisés subió a Dios, y Jehová lo llamó desde el monte, diciendo, Así dirás a la casa de Jacob, y anunciarás a los hijos de Israel.
He's saying, tell these things to the nation of Israel.
A los hijos de Israel.
Hallelujah. And even Stephen in the New Testament, let's go to Acts 7.
Hasta Esteban también testificó en Hechos 7.
And verse 38.
Versículo 38.
Hallelujah. Let's go there now.
Vamos a ir a este verso.
It said, this is he that was in the church in the wilderness with the angel. The angel who spake unto him in Mount Sinai, and with our fathers who received the lively oracles to give unto us.
Este es aquel Moisés que estuvo en la congregación en el desierto con el ángel que le hablaba en el monte Sinaí y con nuestros padres y que recibió palabras de vida que darnos.
Hallelujah. The oracles of life is basically
palabras de vida.
Because Moses was a prophet.
Porque Moisés fue el profeta.
And I want to talk on this Sunday morning.
De esto quiero hablar domingo.
He was called the first week of each month
que estino, la primera
to go before the people of Israel.
Llegó a la gente
and speak the oracles and the will of God into their lives.
A sus vidas.
You see, the church that we call here in the wilderness or
Israel,
God looked at them
el Señor,
not individually
el Señor los tocó, no
but as a corporation.
Sino como una cooperación.
You know, God still looks at the church in that manner.
Dios quiere en esta manera a su iglesia?
He looks at us as a corporation.
Así que tiene que ser como
he
una
doesn't look at us as an individual.
No, ve como un individual.
Hallelujah. And that's why you must come
por
to the house
tú
of the Lord.
Tienes que venir a la casa
you
know,
wonder
Señor.
Why he said, forsake not the assembling
o sea,
of yourselves together.
Que no debes de
there's a reason because you come
sino que venga a la
to receive the oracles of God.
Para que puedas recibir los oráculos
and every time
del
the trumpet sound,
todo el tiempo que la trompeta suena,
here on the mountain it was one long blast.
En el monte estaba,
and they were told to come out together
cuando venían, que venían,
before
que venían
the mountain.
Juntos.
And God would speak unto them.
Señor le habló a ellos.
That's what the trumpet is in the Bible.
Eso fue la trompeta.
It's a warning. If it's a battle,
un aviso.
If it sounds once,
pelea.
It means something.
O cuando
if they play it twice, it means something else.
O cuando te, cuando
but they had to
veces.
Be fine-tuned to what the trumpet was saying. But most of the time it was to assemble together
para que se asambleen juntos.
And hear what the prophet Moses
y aquí el profeta Moisés
had to say unto the people.
Decía a la gente.
But you know what Moses spoke of?
Porque Moisés
another
habló.
Prophet that
Moisés
was to come forth.
Otro profeta que vendría.
To him you must listen.
A este deben escoger.
So when Jesus came forth, he came forth in
cuando
the same
Jesucristo
manner.
Vino, vino la misma manera.
To instruct the people
para instruir a la
to
gente.
Give them direction of the Lord.
Para darles dirección
that's
de
why
Dios.
He was called the great gatherer, the great evangelist.
Por eso que estaba el
he would gather them together. To hear what God
para
had for them.
Qué cosa decía Dios.
And he talked to them about their salvation.
Hablaba de esa salvación.
He talked to them about many things.
Estaba hablando muchas
but he
cosas.
Always gathered them together
pero siempre estaban juntos
to hear the voice of the Lord.
Para escuchar la voz de Dios.
Because when Jesus spoke,
cuando Jesucristo hablaba,
God was speaking.
Dios estaba hablando.
And they were to listen to him.
Y estaban oyendo.
Hallelujah. And this comes from the gathering
y esto cuando estaba
that
en
we
congregación,
see in the Old Testament.
Como lo vemos en el Viejo Testamento.
I'll speak on that more Sunday morning.
Esto voy a hablar
después that was very special
es muy especial
to God, the gathering together
estemos juntos
to hear the prophetic word
para oír la profecía
every
del
first
Señor
Sabbath of the month.
De todos los sábados.
Hallelujah. Do you believe we should do the same thing?
¿Tú crees que queremos
come to hear,
mismo?
Come to the house of the Lord to gather together
Señor y estar juntos,
to hear what the Spirit is saying unto the churches.
Dice a las iglesias.
That's why we gather
es por
together.
Eso estamos juntos.
We seek the Lord together
para
as a corporation
al Señor juntos y prepararnos
to know what God has for us.
Porque Dios sabe, tiene
what is his
para
plan?
Nosotros.
What is his desire towards
¿cuál es su deseo?
Us? Now he's saying, I want you to be the light.
Dijo el Señor, yo quiero
in
que
this
sea la
world,
luz.
I've called you for
que
that purpose.
La luz en este mundo, para ese propósito, te he llamado.
I called Israel first to be the light.
Yo llamé a Israel a ser luz.
Remember what I taught you Sunday night?
Recuerda cuando te dije el domingo,
that
el domingo,
the candle and the light
noche.
Went out.
Que cuando se apagó la lámpara en Jerusalén.
This is why Jesus spoke of the becoming us.
Habló.
The city or the church that is set up on a hill
que la
that it cannot be hidden.
Tiene que estar en un monte,
see, the city is always the church
la ciudad está,
in the New Testament.
La iglesia, del Nuevo Testamento.
The city, the New Jerusalem.
La ciudad, la Nueva Jerusalén.
But the great city was Jerusalem, which their light was turned out on them.
Donde está la luz alumbrando.
They were no longer the light of the
pero
world.
Después ya no fueron la luz.
First Jesus comes to be the true light.
Entonces Jesucristo vino
and then he ordains the
luz.
Church
entonces ordenó su
also
iglesia
to be the light of the world.
Para ser la luz del mundo.
Hallelujah. Now let's go to verse 4.
Voy al versículo 4.
In Exodus verse 19.
Éxodo 19.
You have seen what I did unto the Egyptians and how I bear you on eagle's wings and brought you unto myself.
Vosotros visteis lo que hice a los egipcios, y cómo os tomé sobre alas de águilas, y os he traído a mí.
I believe the Lord has done the same thing.
El Señor está haciendo lo mismo
for His church.
Para su iglesia.
He's bared us on eagle's wings.
Él nos carga
and He's carried
alas,
us literally
águila, y nos carga
all of this time.
Todo este tiempo.
Now I want to go to Isaiah 63.
Voy a Isaías 63.
And verse 9.
Versículo 9.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It said, in all their afflictions he was afflicted, and the angel of his presence saved them. In his love and his pity he redeemed them, and he bared them and carried them all the days of old.
En toda angustia de ellos él fue angustiado. El ángel de su faz los salvó, y en su amor y en su clemencia los redimió, y los trajo y los levantó todos los días de la antigüedad.
Hallelujah. As you read through the history of Israel,
cuando tú lees la historia de Israel,
it talks about the times of old.
Está hablando de estos días.
This is initially when the Lord brought them out of Egypt
esto es cuando el Señor los
and brought them into the promised land.
Y los trajo a la tierra de promesa.
If you look into the book of Zechariah,
cuando tú miras de Zacarías,
it talks about the former prophets
está hablando de este
and the latter prophets.
Y el, y los últimos
the former prophets prophesized during the time that Israel was walking right with the Lord.
Los días en que estaba Israel caminando
the later
bien
prophets
con Dios.
Came forth to bring repentance to Israel because their light was going out as a witness to God.
De ser testigos de
so you must understand these things.
Tienes que entender estas
yes,
cosas.
Israel, you were called to be the light.
Israel fue llamado para
and
ser
we're
la
called
luz.
To be the light.
Nosotros también somos
and we cannot allow the light to go out.
No debemos de dejar apagar
you know who is responsible
lámpara?
To keep the light going in the tabernacle?
¿Te imaginas?
And what are you and I?
Si pasa, si
you and I are responsible the light does not go out
tenía,
in this church.
Que la luz no se va a apagar.
That's why we pray and seek
nosotros
the Lord
también tenemos esta
and say, Lord, send forth your light
por eso buscamos
into
a Dios,
the hearts of all men
Señor, trae esta luz
that they may be saved.
Todos los hombres para que sean salvos.
Hallelujah. Now I want to go back to verse 5.
Voy a regresar a Éxodo 19:5.
Now he's talking to them to be in order to become the light of the world. It talks about you must obey his voice.
También quiso que obedecieran su voz.
Verse 5 says, now therefore if you will obey my voice indeed and keep my covenant, then you shall be a peculiar treasure unto me above all people, for the earth is mine, saith the Lord.
Ahora pues si dieres oído a mi voz y guardares mi pacto, vosotros seréis mi especial tesoro sobre todos los pueblos, porque mía es toda la tierra.
And when did God speak to them through
cuando
his voice?
Dios habló es,
it was through
voz.
The voice of the prophets.
La voz de los profetas.
And the book of Acts tells you
el libro de Hechos,
even though they went to the synagogue
que cuando iban a la synagogue,
hallelujah, to the temple
al templo,
when the law was read
cuando estaban leyendo la
they did not hear the voice of the Lord.
Ellos no oyeron la voz de Dios.
And this is what we have to hear.
Y esto es lo que tenemos que
the
escuchar.
Voice of the Lord.
La voz de Dios.
Did not Jesus say,
no dijo Jesucristo,
my sheep know my
mi ovejas,
voice and they will not follow
mi voz y no
another.
Seguirán la voz extraña.
So you must be familiar.
Tú tienes que ser familiar
with the voice of the Lord
con la voz de tu Dios
as he speaks.
Cuando él habla.
And he does speak through his prophets.
Y él habla a sus profetas.
Hallelujah, and through his ministers.
Y habla a sus ministerios.
What he desires.
Lo que él quiere.
Hallelujah. What I believe the minister of the Lord
yo creo que el ministerio
is to preach
Señor
to the church
es para predicar,
to edify it, to
para
strengthen
edificar
it.
Y para ayudar a la iglesia
I know people say there's prophets given unto the church,
yo sé que hay profetas
but they're only there to edify the church.
Pero todo es para edificar
it's not
iglesia
that I don't believe in prophets,
no es porque no creo
but
profetas,
I believe they're here to edify the church
que tiene que ser para
of the living
iglesia.
God.
La iglesia del Dios
so if anybody calls himself a prophet,
si todos se llaman profetas,
he is there to edify the church of the living God.
Tiene que edificar la iglesia
de
Dios.
And verse 6 says, and ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests and a holy nation. And these are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel.
Y vosotros me seréis un reino reino de sacerdotes, gente santa. Estas son las palabras que dirás a los hijos de Israel.
And later I want to go to the book of 1 Peter to show you that the very same calling that was given to them has now been given to the church so that we may be the light in this dark world. Hallelujah. Now let's go to verse 7.
El versículo 7 de
and Moses came and called for all the elders of the people and laid before their faces all these words which the Lord commanded him.
Entonces vino Moisés y tomó a los ancianos del pueblo y expuso en presencia de ellos todas estas palabras que Jehová le había mandado.
You see, Moses, the prophet of the Lord,
es que Moisés, heard
directly from God.
Directo, su
does not the Bible say he's the only one
dice la Biblia que solamente
that God spoke
él
to face to face?
Hablar con este cara a cara.
If you understand how God speaks to his prophets,
tú entiendas cómo Dios habla
he
a sus
takes
profetas.
Him into a very special place
les
in his chamber,
en un especial
and it's like
lugar
a chamber of counseling
en donde esté un
where,
lugar
the,
de
where the Lord God counsels his
donde
prophets.
El Señor puede consolar a
and
sus
he reveals to them
y revelándoles
what
a
he is about to do.
Qué es lo que se tiene que hacer.
Hallelujah. And the it's in the book of Amos,
como dicen
it said he will
Amos,
not do anything
dice, no hace
until
nada
he reveals
él,
it
si no lo revela,
to his prophets.
Primero a sus profetas.
He revealed to Abraham.
Abraham,
who was a prophet. He revealed many things to David, who was a prophet,
a David,
before he did them.
Antes de,
hallelujah.
Amen.
Now let's go to verse
8.
And all the people answered together and said, all that the Lord has spoken we will do. And Moses returned the words of the people unto the Lord.
Y todo el pueblo respondió a una y dijeron, todo lo que Jehová ha dicho, haremos. Y Moisés refirió a Jehová las palabras del pueblo.
As you will notice here, they are accepting
cuando tú notas que
now that they will be a priest and a royal nation,
para que fuera,
I mean a royal priesthood and a holy nation,
y una
nación and the very light of the world,
que fuera la luz
they have agreed to it.
Estuvieron de acuerdo.
Because Moses, whatever you say,
porque Moisés, no importa
we'll do
lo
it.
Digo, lo vamos a hacer.
And that's including being a light to the Gentile nations.
Incluyeron hacer la luz de las naciones.
Thank you, brother.
Gentiles.
Let's go to Deuteronomy 26.
Deuteronomio 26.
Verse 16 through 19.
16 a 19.
Hallelujah. Let's go to verse 16 first.
Versículo 16.
It says, this day the Lord thy God hath commanded thee to do these statutes and judgments. Thou shalt therefore keep and do them with all thine heart and with all thy soul.
Jehová tu Dios te manda hoy que cumplas estos estatutos y decretos. Cuida pues de ponerlos por obra con todo tu corazón y con toda tu alma.
You know that was a commandment that the Lord gave to the children of Israel,
a los hijos de Israel
because they were to become the light.
Porque iban a ser la luz.
Now I believe those same commandments
ahora,
are given to us
que también nos
that we should love the Lord God with all of our heart,
que se vida
all of our strength,
corazón,
and all of our might.
Nuestro corazón, con toda nuestra mente.
Hallelujah, because he has called us
porque él
to be that very light.
Para ser esa luz.
Verse 17 says, thou hast avouched the Lord this day to be thy God, and to walk in his ways, and to keep his statutes and his commandments and his judgments, to hearken unto his voice.
He declarado, has declarado solemnemente hoy que Jehová es tu Dios y que andarás en sus caminos y guardarás sus estatutos y sus mandamientos y sus decretos y que escucharás su voz.
Aleluya.
Amén.
So when Moses spoke,
Moisés hablando,
it was like God speaking.
Es como Dios hablando.
When the second prophet came forth,
cuando vino el otro profeta,
when he spoke,
cuando hablaba,
he spoke the words of God.
Hablaba las palabras de Dios.
Hallelujah. So you must understand,
tú tienes que entender,
why God ordained them.
Porque Dios lo ordenó.
Hallelujah, that they may hear the voice of the Lord,
para oír la voz
and
de
instruct
Dios,
the people,
y los instruyó,
and cause them to hear the voice of the
para
Lord.
Que oyera la voz de Dios.
Sometimes you will hear the voice of the Lord directly,
a veces tú oye la voz de Dios directamente,
and other times you will hear the voice of the Lord,
y a veces tú oye la voz de Dios,
by what is being preached or taught to you.
Como que te habla a ti.
The Lord is telling you, no, I want you to be the light of the world.
El Señor dice, quiero que
I've called you for this purpose.
Yo te he llamado con este propósito.
Hallelujah. Verse 18.
Versículo 18.
And the Lord hath avouched that this day to be his peculiar people, as he has promised thee, and that thou shouldest keep all of his commandments.
Y Jehová ha declarado hoy que eres pueblo suyo, de su exclusiva posesión, como te lo ha prometido, para que guardes todos sus mandamientos.
And what does God say to the nation that he has called to be his light? I will lift you on high.
Si yo te voy a levantar,
I will set you, like he tells us, I have seated you in spiritual places or in heavenly places.
Te voy a poner en lugares celestiales.
This is basically what he did with the nation of Israel.
Eso es lo que hizo con la nación de Israel.
They were a special people,
y puso especialmente,
and God had set them apart and blessed
y los apartó
them.
Y los bendició.
Verse 19 says, and to
19.
Make thee high above all the nations which he hath made. You mean the Lord made all the nations? Yes, he did. In praise and in name and in honor, and that thou mayest be an holy people unto the Lord thy God as he hath spoken.
A fin de exaltarte sobre todas las naciones que hizo, para loor y fama y gloria, y para que seas un pueblo santo a Jehová tu Dios, como Él ha dicho.
Has he not called us out to be holy also?
¿No nos ha llamado para ser santos
Hallelujah.
También?
You can understand the commandments of the
cuando
Lord.
Puedes entender el mandamiento.
He calls you out to be separate.
Él te dijo que
unto him,
separado,
separated,
él,
holy,
separado,
sanctified,
santo, santificado.
All these are commandments
todos
of the Lord.
Estos mandatos del Señor.
Hallelujah. He says the will of God is the sanctification.
Eso es la of your soul. Es la santificación.
So as you read the word of the Lord,
cuando lees la palabra de Dios,
you will learn what the commandments of the Lord
tú vas a aprender lo que es los
mandamientos, even for us.
Que lo hace para nosotros.
He says, be you holy,
dice, ve,
as
sé
I am
santo,
holy.
Sé santo como
consecrate
yo soy santo.
Your life unto me.
Aleluya.
Don't make any graven images.
Dice, no hagas imágenes.
Don't have another God before
no
me.
Tendrás dioses ajenos.
Hallelujah. Now let's go back to Exodus 19 and verse 9.
Éxodo 19, versículo 9.
And the Lord said unto Moses, Lo, I come unto thee in a thick cloud, that the people may hear when I speak with thee, and believe thee forever. And Moses told the words of the people unto the Lord.
Entonces Jehová dijo a Moisés, He aquí yo vengo a ti en una nube espesa, para que el pueblo oiga mientras que yo hablo contigo, y también para que te crean para siempre. Y Moisés refirió las palabras del pueblo a Jehová.
God has always wanted to lift his people and place them in a high place before the Lord. And that's why I told you the Lord has seated us in heavenly places
in Christ Jesus,
which means we have access to the Almighty. Proverbs tells you to call on to the Almighty.
Hallelujah.
And that is why we are the people of the Lord.
Because
we're called to intercede just like Moses did, just like Abraham.
Abraham.
The church itself is the true prophet of the Lord. Because the sure word of prophecy you will find here in the word of the Lord. And it also says in Revelation that the witness of Jesus is also the true prophecy of God. Hallelujah. Let's continue on. I'm going to go to 1 Peter chapter 2,
Primero Pedro,
verse 9, 5 through 9 this evening.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now he's talking to us
ahora habla a nosotros,
as we're lively stones.
Como una piedra
Hallelujah.
De
but we are the ones that are called out
nosotros somos
to be the very light of the world.
Llamado para ser luz del mundo.
Hallelujah. And we come just like he called Israel.
Así como fue
but
llamado
now he's
Israel.
Calling the church.
Y también llama ahora a su iglesia.
Ye also, as lively stones, are built up a spiritual house. See the difference? Ours is spiritual.
Ahora es un espiritual.
Theirs was carnal.
Casa.
Or according to the law.
De acuerdo con la ley.
And holy priesthood, to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God by Jesus Christ.
Vosotros también como piedras vivas, sed edificados como casa espiritual y sacerdocio santo, para ofrecer sacrificios espirituales aceptables a Dios por medio de Jesucristo.
You notice that they brought in the Lord Jesus Christ into this, to God by Jesus Christ.
Que por medio de Jesucristo.
Now let's go to verse 6. Wherefore also it is contained in the scriptures, behold, I lay in Zion a chief cornerstone, elect, precious, and he that believeth on him shall not be confounded.
Por lo cual también contiene escritura, he aquí pongo en Sion la principal piedra del ángulo escogida, preciosa, y el que creyere en él no será avergonzado.
You know, the prophet Isaiah spoke of this cornerstone.
¿Sabe que el profeta Isaías también habló de esta piedra?
That it would be rejected by the builders.
Esta piedra fue rechazado por los edificadores.
He said he came unto his own.
Por Israel vino a los suyos.
And his own received him not.
Y los suyos no le recibieron.
But he gave power to be the sons of God to those that believe on his name.
Poder de,
so you see the new covenant is being established
through Christ. Establecido por Jesucristo.
And we are to worship and bring forth spiritual sacrifice.
Y traer espiritual sacrificio.
Hallelujah. Christ has already became the great
Jesucristo
and the one and only sacrifice.
Siempre es el único que le
but we bring a sacrifice in another way.
Y nosotros
sacrifice of praise for what Christ
sacrificios
has already done for us.
Es con lo que usted ha
and
hecho
if we are priests, we are to.
Y también
and a priest is also to speak forth the word of the Lord.
Nosotros tenemos que hablar
you'll find
la palabra
that in Malachi, the third chapter, verse 9. I won't go to it now, but it tells you, if you're a priest, what you need to do.
Lo que tú eres un sacerdote,
and the priest always
hacer,
had to bring forth the sacrifice.
El sacerdote trae
and
sacrificios.
So do we.
Nosotros también.
Now let's go to verse 7.
Versículo 7 de 1 Pedro.
Unto you therefore which believe, he is precious, but unto them which be disobedient, the stone which the builders disallowed, the same is made the head of the corner.
Para vosotros, pues, los que creéis, él es precioso. Pero para los que no creen, la piedra que los edificadores desecharon ha venido a ser la cabeza del ángulo.
Hallelujah. No matter what, he is the head of the cornerstone of the church.
Hallelujah.
And we're based upon his teachings.
Estamos nosotros guiados por su enseñanza.
Verse 8, and a stone of stumbling, and a rock of offense, even to them which stumble at his word, being disobedient, whereunto also they were appointed.
Y piedra de tropiezo y roca que hace caer, porque tropiezan en la palabra, siendo desobedientes, a lo cual fueron también destinados.
You mean God knew they would reject the cornerstone?
¿Sabe cómo que rechazaron?
He said, you're appointed unto that because of disbelief. One of the greatest sins in the Bible is not believing or disbelief. Hallelujah, because that controls the rest of your life. Either you believe or you don't believe. And that will control everything in your life, even the way you come to your Lord and everything. You must be a true believer, the one that comes to the house to worship your God and thank him, being grateful, because he has now made you a priest in the house of the Lord to worship him. We cannot be disobedient to what the Lord has called us to be. Because that's what happened to Israel. They no longer saw themselves as priests and servants of the God, of their God. They saw it more as an individual religion. Me and my God, I'm okay. Whether I sacrifice, whether I don't, it's still okay.
Y estoy todo
but God's
bien.
Not that way.
Pero el Señor no es así.
That's why I tell you we are a corporation.
Pero te digo que nosotros somos
the church of the living God.
Estamos juntos.
We're no individuals all by ourselves.
No somos individuales.
We're here to serve the Lord
tenemos
together
que servir a Dios juntos
and become the priest
Si vamos a ser sacerdotes,
the kings that reign with Christ,
reyes, tenemos que reinar con Cristo.
We don't want to be disobedient,
no queremos desobedecer
to our calling of being the light of the world.
Llamamiento para ser luz.
Hallelujah. And let's go to verse 9.
Versículo 9.
Because he says, but you are a chosen generation.
Porque tú eres especial.
Do you realize you've been chosen by God?
Tú eres escogido de Dios.
That's what he's telling you.
Es lo que te está diciendo.
You are a chosen generation.
Hallelujah.
A royal priesthood and holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should shew forth the praises of him who hath called you out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Mas vosotros sois linaje escogido, real sacerdocio, nación santa, pueblo adquirido por Dios, para que anunciéis las virtudes de aquel que os llamó de las tinieblas a su luz admirable.
So you have been called to his marvelous light.
Eres llamado para su admirable luz.
Hallelujah. I want to go now to Matthew.
Voy ahora a Mateo.
Chapter 5, verse 14 through 16.
5, 14.
I want to continue talking about the light.
Yo quiero continuar hablando
that the Lord
de esa
has
luz
called us to be.
Que el Señor ha llamado a que seamos.
The light for our Lord Jesus
la luz
Christ.
Para el Señor Jesucristo.
It says, verse 14.
5,
you
14.
Are the light of the world. A city or the church that is set on a hill cannot be hid.
Vosotros sois la luz del mundo. Una ciudad sentada sobre un monte no se puede esconder.
See, he didn't place us in the valley. He places on top of the hill.
No lo
so that everybody
valle,
can see the light of Christ
de una montaña donde
in
ver
this
todos
world.
En este mundo.
Verse 15.
Versículo 15.
Says, neither do men light a candle and put it under a bushel, but on a candlestick, and it giveth light unto all that are in the house. The house refers to the church.
Ni se enciende una luz y se pone debajo de un almud, sino sobre el candelero y alumbra a todos los que están en casa.
Now what is Christ telling the people? Verse 16.
Ahora Cristo es hablando a su gente.
Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven.
Así alumbre vuestro delante de los hombres, o sea, luz delante de los hombres, para que vean vuestras buenas obras y glorifiquen a vuestro Padre que está en los cielos.
As I told you earlier, the nation of Israel was called to be the light.
But
when you look into Revelation,
it
tells you the candle went out, the light went out,
pero cuando la luz
and they
se
were
apagó,
in darkness.
Ya estaban en
I want to close with Revelation 18,
voy a cerrar con Revelación 18
and verse 23 tonight.
Y versículo 23.
It said, and the light of the candle shall shine no more at all in thee. It's talking about Jerusalem.
Está hablando de Jerusalén.
And the voice of the bridegroom and of the bride shall be heard no more at all in thee. For thy merchants were the great men of this earth, for by the sorceries were all nations deceived.
Luz de lámpara alumbrará más en ti, ni voz de esposo y de esposa se oirá más en ti, porque tus mercaderes eran los grandes de la tierra, pues por tus hechicerías fueron engañadas todas las naciones.
So how did they control the nations?
¿Cómo controlaron las naciones?
It tells you right there.
Te lo dice ahí mismo.
By sorcery, by witchcraft.
Well,
witchcraft is that you want to control someone else and have the power over them.
Y tú quieres tener poder sobre
this
esa
is
persona.
The spirit
ese es el espíritu
that was governing Jerusalem
que estaba gobernando
at
Jerusalén
this time.
En este tiempo.
And this is why he said your candle, the light has gone out.
Dijo que la luz se apagó.
Hallelujah, their light went out.
La luz se apagó.
But now God has a new light.
Pero ahora Diosito tiene
the church,
otra luz, que es la iglesia,
who has become the light of the world.
Que la quiere ser la luz
because
del
their
mundo.
Light went out. They were no longer considered the bride of Christ.
Ya no se puede hacer
you know who is the bride of Christ now?
La esposa de Cristo.
I'm waiting for everyone to answer that.
La iglesia.
Church, we are.
Okay.
La iglesia
the church.
Es la
I want
novia.
You to know that.
Tú tienes que
we are the bride of Christ.
Nosotros somos la
and we are actually married to him
estamos,
because
ya,
he's already brought forth the marriage supper
él.
Of the Lamb
Aleluya.
To the church.
Amen.
The church is married to God.
La iglesia está
and we're
casada.
Promised because he calls us the bride. But the church itself, if you are part of it,
tú eres parte
you
de
are the
iglesia,
wife of God.
Tú eres la luz del mundo.
That makes you kind of special, doesn't it?
Eso te hace ser muy
and
especial.
That's what I want the church to realize. Because there's too many people trying to put down the
que
church
mucha gente que pone abajo
and
la
say we're not the children of God.
Que no somos hijos de Dios.
But that's exactly who we are.
Es exacto lo que somos nosotros.
We are the children of the
nosotros
Most High.
Somos hijos de Dios.
So anytime someone tries to put the church down,
todo el tiempo que la gente
I say, forget
la iglesia abajo,
the
no lo
church
digas.
Is the apple of God's
la,
eye
la iglesia
under
la
the new
los
covenant.
Ojos de Dios.
Because Christ himself died
Cristo murió
for the church
por la iglesia,
and it belongs to him.
Y le pertenece a él.
So the church
la iglesia
is now the people of God.
Es del pueblo de Dios.
Those that have entered in to the apostolic ministry.
Que venga a su mensaje apostólico.
Hallelujah. So what I want you to realize
lo que quiero que veas,
exactly who you are.
Exacto, tú quién eres.
And don't let anyone speak against
no
the church
que nadie hable
of the living God saying it's not important.
But
it is. It's the apple of God's eye.
Porque es la niña
can we stand tonight and lift our hands to the Lord
y pueden
and thank Him?
A Dios.
Dale gracias. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Gracias al Señor.
You've caused us
porque
to be the light
Señor
of the world.
Jesucristo.
Hallelujah, we are no longer in darkness. Because that light has shined into our hearts. The light of the gospel of Christ, hallelujah. And I ask you to continue to shine in the lives of your people tonight. As the bride of Christ, hallelujah. We are to shine before men. We are indeed the light of the world. So let us let our light shine before men, that they will see our good works, and they will glorify our God. I want to thank you, Lord Jesus, for making your church the very light of this world. And we are special to you, because you've always had in mind your church that would love you and serve you. And you had to look, and you did. And you found us where? In the Gentile nation that would love you and serve you and glorify you in our midst. Thank you, Jesus.
Gracias, gracias.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Gracias.
So you see, you are the light of the world.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise God.
We're not in darkness.
No estamos en oscuridad.
And we're not in the wilderness.
No estamos en el
you know why?
¿Sabes por qué?
The Lord is leading us.
Porque el Señor nos está guiando.
He is leading us through
nos
with
está
His Spirit.
Guiando con su espíritu.
That's why I said the church is not in
por
the
eso,
wilderness.
La iglesia no está en el desierto.
We have gone. Christ went through the wilderness for
Cristo,
you and I.
Cristo fue al desierto.
And the 40 days that He was tempted,
40 días fue tentado,
the Spirit
Señor.
Took Him to where? The wilderness. To be tempted of the devil. Hallelujah. So I don't believe the church is in the wilderness.
Yo no creo que la iglesia
it's in the
está
kingdom
en
of God.
Está en el reino de
that's
Dios.
Who we are and that's
es
where we're
somos,
at.
Y eso es lo que estamos.
So may the Lord bless you tonight.
Señor, te bendigan esta noche.
Shine His countenance upon you.
Resplandezca su rostro sobre
and give
ti.
You peace and rest.
Te dé paz y descanso.
You're dismissed in His name tonight. God bless you.
En el nombre, Señor Jesucristo.